and then this is the school going to be.
Dhruba was the last person you'd ever expect to reach for the stars.
My parents is farmer, but I never finished the school.
He came from a poor village in the jungles of Nepal and worked as a waiter to tourists who came on safari. One day at the restaurant, he had a long chat with a couple visiting from the Netherlands. They asked him an unusual question.
And I didn't know why. They asked me, what is your dream? They asked my dream. And I was surprised a little bit. And then I just shared my dream with them.
But broke with no cash, Dhruba forgot about his dream and the Dutch tourist. Until the day a letter arrived.
They sent me the letter. And then they say, we have money for you. And please send us your bank account. And I was surprised. I could not believe it. You know, they say, they're just making joke or is it real? I thought they're making joke.
With a backpack full of cash, Dhruba bought land from a rice farmer and started building a hotel. A hotel he named Sapana Village.
And I give the name called Sapana Village. And Sapana means dream. And I work for the dream.
Sapana Village looked nothing like other hotels in the jungle. He built his lodges to look like a traditional Tharu village.
Tharu are the original people. They should get some money back from the tourism, but nothing they get.
So in addition to the typical tourist activities, elephant rides and safari trips, Dhruba asked Tharu families to show his guests their traditional ways of life.
They go to Tharu village, they make henna tattoo, and they pay for money. And 50% money directly go to the community. And then also like a Tharu cooking class. They have a special house, and they build this typical Tharu house, and then they can see, they can learn the culture each other, is learning each other, and also these Tharu people getting the job, they can teach them how to make the food.
At Sapana Village, you'll find room cleaners and waiters, but you won't find a big boss walking around giving orders.
Now I'm sending my staff for the tour for 4 days. There, I feel like, okay, they work very hard, they need to some time. And they were having 4 day tour to go to study something and learn something and see some different things. You know, this is the way we are trying to do together working, yeah.
Now we're going to the, yeah, this is our workshop place.
Dhruba now puts his profits into local development projects.
There's more than 13 women working, and also this is all the Tharu village women, they do handicraft things like workshop.
They are a carpenter.
For many of us, dreams are about getting something. They're selfish. But for Dhruba, dreaming means giving.
And then this is the school going to be. And now there's an office and kitchen room, and then 2 classrooms.
You born naked, you go naked. But only things you need to eat morning and evening, 2 times good food. That's it you need, and some clothes. When you are born here, you have to do something for the earth, for this place, you know, before you go. That is my feeling and my philosophy, and I work for that.